gather today to celebrate the seventh Sunday of Easter, praying together that we all remain healthy as we work through this difficult time.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
Lord Jesus, you have shown us the way to the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you have given us the consolation of the truth. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the good shepherd, leading us into everlasting life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Praise you.
Graciously hear our supplications, O Lord, so that we, who believe that the Savior of the human race is with you in your glory, may experience, as you promised, until the end of the world, his abiding presence among us, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. Reading from the Acts of the Apostles. After Jesus had been taken up to heaven, the apostles returned to Jerusalem from the mount called Olivet, which is near Jerusalem, a Sabbath day's journey away. When they entered the city, they went to the upper room where they were staying, Peter and John and James and Andrew, Philip and Thomas, Bartholomew and Matthew, James the son of Alphaeus, Simon the Zealot, and Judas son of James. All these devoted themselves with one accord to prayer, together with some women, and Mary the mother of Jesus and his brothers. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Of whom should I be? first letter of St. Peter. Beloved, rejoice to the extent that you share in the sufferings of Christ, so that when his glory is revealed, you may also rejoice exultantly. If you are insulted for the name of Christ, blessed are you, for the Spirit of glory and of God rests upon you. But let no one among you be made to suffer as a murderer, a thief, an evildoer, or as an intriguer. For whoever is made to suffer as a Christian should not be ashamed, but glorify God because of the name. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
With your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus raised his eyes to heaven and said, Father, the hour has come. Give glory to your Son, so that your Son may glorify you. Just as you gave him authority over all people, so that your Son may give eternal life to all you gave him. Now this is eternal life, that they should know you, the only true God, and the one whom you sent, Jesus Christ. I glorified you on earth by accomplishing the work that you gave me to do. Now glorify me, Father, with you, with the glory that I had with you before the world began. I revealed your name to those whom you gave me out of this world. They belong to you, and you gave them to me, and they have kept your word. Now they know that everything you gave me is from you, because the words you gave to me I have given to them. And they accepted them and truly understood that I came from you. And they have believed that you sent me. I pray for them. I do not pray for the world, but for the ones you gave and have given me, because they are yours, and everything of mine is yours, and everything of yours is mine. And I have been glorified in them, and now I will no longer be in the world, but they are in the world while I am coming to you. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
One evening, a mother was walking down the hallway when she happened to notice her 5-year-old daughter kneeling by her bed with her hands in prayer. So she
Pikachu was just saying her nighttime prayers, except as she walked by, she seemed to be just hearing her say the alphabet. So the mother went in and said, "What are you doing?" The little girl said, "I'm praying." And the mother says, "No, you're not. You're saying the alphabet." The little girl said, "Well, I don't know what to pray for, so I just say all the letters and I let God put them any way he wants to." That is a good way of thinking about prayer. So many of us, I think, we pray in specifics. We don't just pray for what we want, we pray for how we want it, when we want it, and everything else to go with it. In our first reading, of course, we hear the disciples and the women in the upper room. Jesus has left them, and they haven't yet received the Holy Spirit. So what do? They pray. The gospel, of course, is part of Jesus' high priestly prayer, where he's already prayed for himself, his disciples, and then he prays for all of us, for all eternity, those here now and those who will come. Prayer is essential to being a Christian and to being a Catholic. When I first entered the seminary, one of the things we all have to do is meet with a spiritual director. I met with mine, and I don't know if it was the first time I met with him or one other time, but I remember him soon asking me, "How did I pray?" And of course, I told him, "Well, I start with my mother and my father, then my brothers and sisters-in-laws, and then my nieces and nephews, and down the line, and on and on and on." And he said, "Stop." Well, I wasn't about to stop. But afterwards, I did think about it. And in a way, he was right, because I really did kind of have that idea that if I left someone out and something happened to them, it was my fault. As if I was controlling God with my prayers. And then if I accidentally forgot to pray for someone and something happened, I've actually come a long way. And even with this virus, for the most part, my prayer is, "God, let everything be all right." However you do it, however you see fit, whatever you're going to do, just let everything be all right. And that might not even mean that we're all going to be healthy, we're all going to get through this the way we want to, but it can still be all right. And I think that's something we forget. Sometimes I think we get so wrapped up in praying for this or that, that we forget. Ultimately, God is in charge. And God is in charge in a way that we can't even really begin to imagine. It's funny, but the more I learned of physics, the more I really understood a little bit better about God. We know about quantum mechanics, we know about string theory, we know about all these things. Nobody can really explain them. That's kind of really what God is like, because he's outside of time and space. So that our prayers in the past can help someone in the future can help someone in the past, and of course our prayers can help now. There's a story about an African missionary. She was in a remote part, and one day she found out that one of their villagers, a young mother who was pregnant, was having difficulties. She actually gave birth to a premature baby, but died in childbirth, not only leaving the premature baby, but also a two-year-old. She didn't know how to really deal with this, but it was time for prayer, so they told everyone what was going on. And this one little girl says a prayer something like this: "Okay, God, we need a hot water bottle now. Tomorrow will be too late because this baby needs to be kept warm, and we need it today. And we also could use a little dolly for the two-year-old sister so she knows you love her." Well, a few hours later, a package arrives. A package that had been packed 5 months before. And as they open the box, sure enough, there's a brand new hot water bottle. The sister herself, who was the missionary, said, "I don't even know why anyone would think of sending a hot water bottle to a remote part of Africa where we're on the equator and it's like boiling hot all the time." But with that hot water bottle, she just had this feeling. And at the bottom of the box was a brand new doll. She thought to herself, too, about how mysterious God is. That somehow, 5 months before, people would answer a prayer that was said by a little girl that very day. You see, prayer in itself is mysterious. We know that it isn't going to change God. It's not going to cause God to do what we want him to do. But I think too often that is what we think. I can remember a time when my nephew was about 6 years old and we were playing chutes and ladder, and he folded his little hands and prayed that he would get on that ladder that only went to the top, and he did it. And he was so excited. And he knew God loved him. And the next time he rolled the dice, he got that chute that went all the way back to the bottom. Now he was quite sure God hated him. But at 6 years old, what do you expect? But think about it. Isn't that sometimes what we do? We think of God as maybe some kind of a vending machine. If we deposit enough prayers, we'll get what we want. Or maybe we think of him as kind of a genie in a lamp. If we rub it the right way, we'll get what we want. But we have to remember, it's not just about getting what we want. It's about being part of this great community, this great body of Christ, where we are all in this together. And we will suffer in different ways, and different people will have different experiences. But the idea of being together in prayer is that we're there for each other. You know, in the second reading, when Peter talks about suffering for the sake of Christ, I don't think anyone really wants to suffer for any reason. But we have to admit, if we suffer because we've done something foolish or wrong, well, so be it. But on the other hand, if we've done nothing wrong, and we suffer because we're Christians, or if we even just suffer remotely, but we can still reflect on God's love for us and still share that love with others, even in our suffering, then that is the sign of a true Christian, and probably the best way to try to bring others into what we believe and to be part of this community. Prayer is essential, but not every form of prayer is going to resonate with every single person. Another thing that we found out in the seminary were different personality types often gravitate to different forms of prayer. Some of you may already know that you like devotional prayer. You actually enjoy sitting, saying the rosary either together or by yourself, or maybe the Divine Mercy prayer. Others might not really feel the same way. But on the other hand, you might enjoy just seeing God in nature, talking to him when you see a beautiful sunset. Because what is prayer but talking to God? Talking like he's with us in a way that we would talk to a friend or a relative or someone else we love. Jesus promised that he would be with us forever. Jesus is. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit can't be separated, so they are all with us. I have to admit now in my older age, I'm forgetting a lot of things. And whenever I suddenly recall it, and I have no idea why I recall it at that time, but I really needed to recall it, I just simply say, thank you. And I kind of give credit to the Holy Spirit, because I think the Holy Spirit's the one that's really got the wings. Prayer is not going to be the same for everyone, but it is always to bring us together. I am quite convinced the reason that the Mets beat the Red Sox in 1986 is because for the first time, both the Mets fans and the Yankee fans were praying for the same thing, because the Yankee fans can't stand the Red Sox. Unfortunately, I think the Mets still hate the Yankees too much that even when they played the Red Sox, it didn't work. Not all the time, anyway. I think there is something, though, too, communal prayer, to being together, to holding on to one another. After all, we know scientifically and physically that everything is energy. So why not prayer, too? Prayer in some way that we're not changing God, but maybe we're changing others and we're changing ourselves. Prayer in a way in which maybe we do can affect outcomes, simply because we believe and trust. We're not always going to get what we want. If we're praying for someone to get better and they don't get better, it's not because God doesn't love us. It simply just wasn't meant to be. But God is with us, through this time, suffering and the good times. But sometimes I think most of our prayers are asking for things. I want this or I want that. We forget that probably the most essential prayer is simply thank you for all that we already have, all that you've already given to us, everything that you do for us. Now, one day there was a little boy. He was with his parents at his grandmother's house. And when they sat down for dinner, they immediately started to eat. And his mother said, Jack, you know we always say prayers before we eat. And he looked at his mom and said, but Mom, we're at grandma's house. And his mother said, yeah, so I know. But we still pray. But why? Grandma knows how to cook. Chuckles even here. We all have different ideas of prayer, but hopefully the main essential thing is really gratitude. Thanks for what God has done for us, and knowing that God is with us. There's one little other story, and it's two men that are shipwrecked on an island. They decide to see who is the worthiest, so they divide the island in two, and they decide to pray. Well, on one side, a person prays for food, and the next day, there is a bush with food that he can eat. On the other side, nothing. The next day, that man prays for shelter, and all of a sudden, out of magic, there's a little shelter for him to live in. The other side, nothing. The next day, he prays for rescue, and the ship comes to his side of the island. He gets onto the ship, but he's going to leave the other one behind, feeling he's not worthy, since none of his prayers were answered. But God says to him, why are you leaving without your friend? He says, well, I prayed, and everything came to me. He prayed, and nothing came to him. And God said, oh, no, you're wrong. He had only one prayer, and it was answered. And his prayer was that all of your prayers would be answered. You see, maybe sometimes our prayers are answered not because of our prayers, but because of others. So all the more reason to always thank God.
Visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things are made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified, Pontius Pilate, suffered death and was buried, rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Let us imitate Christ in his prayer for his church.
Our response is, Lord, hear our prayer. We pray for our church that we may continue the work of Christ each day. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our parish family, that the people of every race and culture who seek Christ may find a welcome among us, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For leaders of governments everywhere, that they may bring peace by seeking justice for the world's poor, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an end to fear and hysteria, which prevents people from working together in the midst of the global spread of the coronavirus, and that all will be kept safe from its effects. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all who have been killed in the world's wars, and for those who mourn them, and that God's world may be delivered from the scourges of war. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all the sick, especially Eric Buchnowski, Barbara Pugh, Sally Maggio, and Grace Judd, that they may find healing in the knowledge that they are loved by God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the faith who departed. We pray especially for John Kramer, that he may see the God in whom he had hoped. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Pray for the intentions in our prayer intentions book, and the prayers we keep deep within our own hearts, and for Anita and Mario, Alfonso Aviles, Joseph Cayola, Helen McGrath and Carmelina Rodriguez, Alfonso Aviles, and the people of the parish, Joseph Cayola, Helen McGrath, and Carmen Rodriguez, for whom this Mass is offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. prayer.
Holy God, we pray with your Son that we and all people may enter into the fullness of life that he won for us in his death and resurrection. We ask these things in his name, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
His resurrection, He plainly appeared to all his disciples and was taken up to heaven in their sight, that he might make us sharers in his divinity. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers of the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Similar way when supper was ended, he took the chalice, gave you thanks, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and martyrs, with St. Francis Cabrini, and with all the saints shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Divine in you.
Let us pray. Hear us, O God, our Savior, and grant us confidence that through these sacred mysteries, there will be accomplished in the body of the whole Church what has already come to pass in Christ her head, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
At this time, we have been told that we can have small gatherings of no more than 10 people and still practicing social distancing and other health precautions. In addition, at this time, even if we do have masses, no one is allowed to receive communion. With the restrictions still changing, we hope to be able to welcome you back to Eucharist soon. Until then, we continue to pray for all in the healthcare profession and essential workers and for each other. Have a happy and safe Memorial Day weekend. Stay healthy and keep praying.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow down for God's blessing.
May God, who by the resurrection of his only begotten Son was pleased to confer on you the gift of redemption and of adoption, give you gladness by his blessing.
Amen.
May he, by whose redeeming work you have received the gift of everlasting freedom, make you heirs to an eternal inheritance.
Amen.
And may you, who have already risen with Christ in baptism through faith, by living in a right manner on this earth, be united with him in the homeland of heaven.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and be with you forever.
Amen. Let us go in peace.